Hello guys, and welcome to another episode from SportsZN. So IPL auction for 2021 season has been has happened at Chennai, and there has been some interesting picks that teams have picked up. Now I have with me Vignesh from Knowledgeable Chennai and Sailesh from Dashing Hyderabad. Hi Vignesh, hi Sailesh. So how did you feel the auction was?
I was actually really excited for the auction and was looking forward for it because, I mean, despite this being a mini auction, the IPL auction itself brings a whole different dynamic to the game of cricket. I mean, you see it only once in a year. It's like a 3 hour or a 4 hour or a 6 hour affair for which we have to wait for an entire year. So for me, I really find it very fascinating.
The auction was actually... not surprising as such, because yeah, we expected few players to go for big bucks, especially for the teams like Kings, Chennai, RCB to fill their vacant slots. Obviously, they've had their plans to get their marquee players in their team, so it was not a big surprise. But especially with few players going for big bucks, yeah, that was a surprise, and I feel happy for the local lads at least. A lot of them got picked in this auction.
Yeah, we'll start off with Chennai Super Kings. I mean, Chennai had a very, a disastrous 2020 season, and they were really hoping to get a go at this time. They had some interesting picks. So Krishnappa Gautam, who has got picked, base price of 20 lakhs, got picked for 9.25 crores.
Yeah, with respect to Krishnappa Gautam, I mean, we know that this guy is more talented. So if we follow the cricket closely, Karnataka Premier League, he was the best player in the whole league. So he played pretty well for the last two seasons. So it was not a surprise that Krishnappa Gautam went for big bucks, but 9.25, I don't know how far he'll be doing justice for that figure as such, being it only for a year.
I feel that CSK did pretty well in this auction, considering they were able to plug the holes which were lacking last year, which was the opener overseas slot, which Moeen Ali can play. He can bowl off spin as well. And Krishnappa Gautam, of course, is a replacement for Harbhajan Singh in the off spin department. And I am not really bothered about the price. I know 9.25 is quite a big amount for an uncapped player, but still I'm not worried about the price, because this is just going to be for 1 year, and if at all he is not going to perform, obviously they're going to release him.
Chateshwar Pujara is also been an interesting pick. I mean, there was debate when Pujara got listed for this thing. I mean, he's definitely he's undoubtedly a great player in the whites, but you never know how will he play in the short format of the game. But
I don't really see Pujara playing for most of the matches, probably just to bring his experience for the team, because he plays spin pretty well. And so we might see him playing games only in Chennai, because he handles spin better. Not that he plays pretty slow. A 130, 140 run in Chennai with an MS Dhoni leadership and the spin over there, they can win matches. That's not a big deal for them.
Yes, I think they had a strategy, which was, last year when CSK's top order used to crumble, I always felt that a player who like S. Badrinath, you know, who was a CSK legend, he used to be the anchor of the inning. So maybe Pujara can play that role.
I believe this season CSK would have a lot of players just smashing the ball, which having Pujara in between. So he can play the anchor role and rest others, including what Jaddu has shown in last season. He went bonkers, literally, like what Hardik Pandya has done. So, yep, Chateshwar Pujara at a 50 lakh price would be a best buy for them.
Yeah, so that's with CSK is now moving on to Delhi Capitals. They too had some interesting buys, I would say. They picked up Steve Smith for 2.2 crores. I think any IPL team given any day, I think it's a best price. It's a win-win for the team, I would say. They too picked up Tom Curran and Sam Billings at almost a pretty low prices, I would say.
I am seeing Delhi's auction strategy as a like-for-like replacement and as a ways to plug in holes. So the way they plugged in holes was because last season they lacked an Indian fast bowling department. Of course, they had Ishan Sharma and Mohit Sharma, but both of them were injured and did not perform. So they had to rely on the two overseas pacers. So this time they've gotten Umesh Yadav as well. Ishan Sharma hopefully is fit for the season. And of course, they've brought in Lukman Meriwala, who has really impressed in the Sailing Star Elite tournament.
A couple of things which surprised me was, yes, Steve Smith won. Going for just 2.2. I don't know where will Steve Smith fit in their team as such. With a like-to-like player like Ajinkya Rahane, if they play both Rahane and Smith together again, it becomes an RR, which happened previously, where the scoring rate goes down. And another one is Umesh Yadav. So I feel Umesh Yadav would be a better buy for them. So he might perform better when compared to other buys, as his performance with RCB speaks out for the initial overs.
Yeah, I mean, DC management has made sure that they will do anything to make Steve Smith play start in the playing 11, actually. So I don't know who would be sacrificing that OC slot player. And also, I mean, Michael Clark had made some interesting statements, actually. He said that it's not sure that Smith would want to travel to India because he's been just being 3,800 USD and stay away from his family for 11 weeks. So do you think, is that a possibility with Smith to do such thing?
That is something which we can't, say. But yeah, 2.2 for a player of Steve Smith caliber and making him sit on bench would be the worst possible thing which generally happens. And there was another comment made by one of the commentators saying, yes, you can't make players like Steve Smith, Ajinkya Rahane, Shikhar Dhawan, one of these three sitting in the bench, which will be demoralizing for the team if they don't align with the team strategy as such. But yeah, with Ricky Ponting in place, should not be a big problem for them.
Next team in our lineup is Punjab Kings, the newly named Punjab Kings. So they've changed their names from Kings XI Punjab. I hope their fortunes also change with the name. And they really gone big bugs on the bowlers, because bowling unit has been one thing that definitely hurt them in the 2020 IPL. And they've spent big bucks on Jai Richardson and Riley Murdett. Riley Murdett particularly had a pretty good BBL season, and that definitely paid off for him. And according to my view, the best buy of this IPL has been David Malan, the number one T20 batsman. He just got at the base price. And they too got Moises Henriques, Fabian Allen and Shahrukh Khan. It's a pretty interesting buys.
If you just look at the buys, obviously Kings XI Punjab surprises every time. Punjab Kings also surprised, but in a positive way this time. They can make out their four foreigners with the buys which they had now. Four perfect foreigners to fit in the team. You say David Malan, Fabian Allen or Moises Henriques. They can start off with both Riley Meredith and Jai Richardson.
I felt that last season they lagged in Indian batting depth. Simran Singh, and it hasn't worked out. Of course, Maxwell failing has not helped them. Right, Sarfraz was there. Karun Nair was there. Was he? Right, yeah. I think Karun Nair was also there.
Yes, he was there.
And Maxwell failing hasn't helped their middle order. So this time, the acquisition of Shahrukh Khan, I feel, is really important for them. Probably, I would say it is one of the best buys in this IPL, because it plugs a hole in their ship. And David Malan, I do think that for the price he was got, it's a really big bargain. But when you see the position where David Malan plays, which is basically number three, they have the universe boss over there. So will they really sacrifice universe boss for David Malan? I don't see that happening. And I see David Malan playing second fiddle to Chris Gayle. And if David Malan had been in any other team apart from Kings XI Punjab, he would have definitely made the starting 11. But being in Kings XI Punjab and when you have a player like Chris Gayle over there, I don't see David Malan coming in the playing 11.
I think with respect to Shahrukh Khan, but we need to see whether Kings will give him a long rope, even if he doesn't perform. That is something which they have to make sure that they give him some spot of, okay, we say that, okay, yeah, we give you that confidence, you go and play irrespective of your failures. If they do that, yeah, probably that would be a good strategy. And second thing, with respect to David Malan, I feel that at least for first 5 to 6 games he has to play, so that Universe Box get that fire and he'll do the same what he has done in 2020 as such.
The next team is Kolkata Knight Riders. If you haven't watched, the second gen family has attended the auction. So King Khan Sanz was there, and I think there has been some pretty interesting buys. Shakib Al Hasan is back with KKR, with whom he had won two trophies, 2012 and 2014. And he got sold out for 3.2 crores. But I felt that if Bangladesh didn't have that, BCCI didn't issue that, order that Bangladesh players might not be available after May 15th, I think Shakib would have fetched more price and teams would have wanted him in his team. And Harbhajan has found a third team now. After being let go by CSK, and now he's at KKR. So do you think he has got a role to play?
Yes, I think Harbhajan Singh has got a role to play. Again, not as a first team player, maybe as a second team player, because Varun Chakravarti, I think, has sealed the first spinner slot. Maybe Kuldeep Yadav to bring some variations, but Harbhajan Singh would be third in the pecking order. And Shakib Al Hasan, yes, I think probably the best buy in this IPL, considering the variety he brings, subject to his availability. But if he is available for a lot of games, then KKR will definitely rely more on their overseas players, because last time we saw Pat Cummins was good in patches. Andre Russell was injured for half of the time. Sunil Narain was... his form was suffering because of the suspect action. So Shakib Al Hasan will definitely bring in more stability. And I feel that, KKR still lacks in the Indian fast bowling department. They have Prasidh Krishna, they have Shivam Mavi and Nagar Koti, but I feel that doesn't have much experience. Maybe they should have gone for Umesh Yadav. He was picked at a base price. So I think that would have reinforced their team much better.
I see a mindset change in KKR's auction strategy as such, because if you look at our previous years, they used to have a team of 18 to 20. They were satisfied with that team, and they had proper four foreigners where they can play all the 14 matches, which backfired in last year when it comes to Andre Russell. So a buy of Ben Cutting was probably the best strategy which they've gone through. For example, where matches where Andre Russell is not fit for bowling, they can immediately go for a replacement of Ben Cutting. He can do well in bowling and batting and fielding department also. So that's an exact like-to-like replacement for him. And to add the point, they don't have that experience in Indian fast bowling department. Have to see going forward how will they do with respect to the fast bowling. But they might go with three spinners also. When the matches are played in Kolkata, they might go with a Harbhajan, Varun Chakravarti, might be a Kuldeep Yadav or a Pawan Negi. They have proper spinners in the team. They can do that also. They have the luxury to do that.
So next, moving on to the defending champions for a straight third season, Mumbai Indians. So it's my favorite team. And I would say that they've done pretty decent in the auction. They've let go Nathan Coulter-Nile for eight crores. And they've got Nathan Coulter-Nile and Adam Milne for almost the same 8 crores. They've justified that. And they've got Piyush Chawla as well. 2.4 crores, and they got an all-rounder in James Neesham. And the Tendulkar's name is coming back. They picked up Arjun Tendulkar for 20 lakhs and an exciting Marco Jansen as well. So what do you guys think about my team's picks?
So first thing, the wonderful thing which they've done is to retain the core. They have this habit of having the same players in their team. So irrespective of the paycheck, they've got alternate back in the team. And they've got an Adam Mill. Probably if Coulter-Nile is not fit, they can replace him immediately with Mill with the performance which he had in DBA. He was consistent around 145, 150s, which adds a value in the team. And Neesham, probably I would say they didn't buy him as an all-rounder. They would look him more as a batsman, not just a bowler, to give him more confidence if they play. That is again case where if Kyron Pollard isn't fit. And we don't see that happen generally. So he would be sitting in for most of the games. And yeah, Arjun Tendulkar, so that is something which Himant has to comment, which I can't comment.
I feel that, just like any other team, they have really plugged in the gaps well. And one of the most important gaps which they have plugged is Piyush Chawla. So they generally have only two spinners. I mean, both of them play in the same match, which is this guy, Krunal Pandya, and Rahul Chahal. And as a backup, maybe Jayant Yadav. So I mean, bringing a person of Piyush Chawla's caliber is really good, which Mumbai has done. And I wanted to talk about this. I mean, Mumbai had 15 crores in their purse, and when they bid for Chris Morris for 13 crores, I think all the other teams should have, you know, let Mumbai take Chris Morris just to shut them out of the auction. I mean, with two other crores, I'm sure they would not have bought Kultanail, they would not have bought Piyush Chawla, they would not bought Adam Mill, they would not bought Nisham and Marco Jensen. That would have really crippled them. But of course, I know that it's, you know, every team has to think about themselves first. But I felt that this could have been a really interesting strategy if the other teams had pulled it off.
Yeah, agreed. I mean, but you never know like what they've been thinking. I mean, I would like to speak about Marco Jensen for people who don't know him. He's a South African fast bowler. You just Google up. He has got some impressive stats there. And it seemed that Quinton de Kock was pretty much interested in him. Quinton de Kock wanted to get him at any price. And even Zahir Khan stated that they were ready to bid more than 20 lakhs. And he was surprised that there was no bidding going around him. And he was more than happy to see. And you know how good Mumbai's scouting thing is. Like, yes. They got Bumrah, they got Pandyas for 20 lakhs, 30 lakhs. And they made world-class cricketers. They are world-class cricketers now.
Sasha Bogle was saying, every team has to have a strategy of bidding for the players which Mumbai bids, because they have the best scouting strategy at any cost.
Yeah. Now, moving on to Rajasthan Royals. Now, they've broken all-time IPL record. They bid 16.25 crores to Chris Morris. And that breaks the previous record for Yuvraj Singh. Okay, and apart from Chris Morris, I believe the second best pick of this IPL has been Mustafizur Rahman. He was just applying for 1 crore. And I really believe that he's worth more than 1 crore, technically speaking. And they've got Livingston too for a base price of 75 lakhs.
And coming to Chris Morris, I think I don't mind the price. Like I said, this is a mini auction. It's just going to be for 1 year. If they want, they can release him. But was Chris Morris the best all-rounder in this auction to go all out for him? I am doubtful about that. He's a really good hard hitter. He's a really good death bowler. But the most important issue with him is injury crisis. He very often gets injured. That's why his career has been hampered. So I'm not sure if Chris Morris is the best all-rounder in this auction. Maybe Jai Richardson is not as good as with the bat, but he is definitely much fitter than Morris and much younger. So maybe they could have gone for Richardson.
Yep, but one thing which everyone has to know is Rajasthan Royals just plays with four foreigners. That's it. They don't even shell out money for other replacements as such. And if you look at the same way, but one good thing which they've done is they've let go Steve Smith. And they've got a support for Jofra Archer. They believe that they know that they don't have a strong Indian bowling lineup. So one good thing which they've done is getting Chris Morris at that price, irrespective of whatever it might be, because it's just for one season. And second good thing which they've done is getting Shivam Dubey. So they didn't have an Indian batsman to play when they had these Stokes, Butlers, etc., etc., etc. So now Shivam Dubey, if he performs well, he can be a good finisher along with Rahul Tevatiya and Priyan Parag, which they played with last season. That was a gamble actually. But this season, adding a Shivam Dubey to that lineup brings more consistency and stability.
Yeah, so the next team in the lineup is Royal Challengers of Bangalore. So they went all out. They had much bigger pockets with them. They really spent this time. They bought Kylie Jameson for 15 crores. Glenn Maxwell for 14.25 crores. And they performed decent. And I would say the masterstroke is Dan Christian. He's been pretty good form in BBL.
Yeah. So before we talk about the price for RCB, the first thing is they've performed well in last season compared to the previous seasons. Yeah. And still, they've let go 12 players. And I don't know what's the reason, but what's the line of thought, but they've let go 12 players. They've done some pretty good buys, irrespective of how Maxwell plays. Maxwell fits well in the team. He takes away the pressure of Virat Kohli's and AB de Villiers. So that is one of the better buys. And apart from that, Dan Christian. So if we follow BBL carefully, the kind of background which he brings, the kind of reputation which Dan Christian brings, he's a trophy holder. So probably kind of luck also plays a picture over here. And if that happens, yeah, probably we'll see RCB at least in one or two positions this year. Hope it happens.
I would say hope it doesn't happen as a CSK fan. and I do agree with both of you that Dan Christian's a really good buy. He's a serial winner. He has won tournaments in England, New Zealand, and recently in Australia as well with the Sydney Sixers. Kyle Jameson is a really good buy. He is still unproven in Indian territory, but I think he has the talent. Maxwell, of course, like I said, just one season, better go for him. His name makes RCB look better. But again, I feel that there is a lack of Indian batting in this team. They have let go of Shivam Dubey. They have Washington Sundar, who's going to come lower in the order. So who's going to fit in that number five role? I don't know. They have Gazruddin, who has a good reputation. He's playing for Kerala. But are they really, they got Sachin Baby as well, who played in the 2016 finals. But are they really going to, you know, bring that stability into RCB's starting 11? We'll have to wait and see.
It's about the Indian players which they've brought in. So if you look at the Indian players, so they've got Harshal Patel, they've got Sachin Baby, Shrikar Bharat, all these, Mohammad Azharuddin also. So all these have performed consistently in the domestic circuits. Be it a Ranji Trophy, Vijay Hazare, their performances have spoken out. But we need to see what is the confidence which will be given by the RCB management to these players. Where will they fit in that team? That is a bigger thing, because RCB, I feel, they don't know how much time they'll give to these players if they don't perform.
Okay, now moving on to the last team in the list. It's Sunrisers Hyderabad. So they didn't have much left in the purse. So they bought pretty much everybody at the base price, you can say. They bought Kedar Jadhav for 2 crores, Muzeeb for 1.5, Jagdish Ashushit for 30 lakhs. So what do you think? The team that has bought the least number of players, actually.
For SRH, I feel they are making it really difficult for them to get 4 overseas players. Because right from the off, you can see that they are a top-heavy team. I mean, a batting top-heavy team with not much Indian batting. So basically, David Warner and Johnny Bairstow are going to play both. And of course, Kane Williamson, undoubtedly. So that's 3 of the 4 slots gone. And 4th should mostly go to Rashid Khan, considering he's a mystery spinner. But they have quality all-rounders like Mitchell Marsh, Jason Holder, who played a match-winning innings in last year's Eliminator. They have a Mohammad Nabi. And now, I don't know why they've got Mujibur Rahman as well. So it's puzzling, but they are spoiled for choices. And considering the Indian batting, it's lean. Like we have told, there is Vijay Shankar, Manish Pandey, both didn't have really great tournaments last year. So they've tried to bring in Kedar Jadhav, who ironically, again, did not have a great tournament last year. But let's see how it's fitting. And of course, I always felt that they needed an Indian spinner. They bought in Suchit. I don't know if he's going to fit the bill, but we'll wait and see.
Pretty much going into the auction, I guess SRH team is the brand ambassador for Colon Mattresses, because they had nothing to do over there. They just came for the auction to see what's exactly happening. But one interesting by Kedar Jadhav, hope he performs. If he performs, that's the only gap which they had in the team. I don't see Johnny Bairstow opening in the team as such. They'll go either with a Jason Holder or a Mitch Marsh, a Rashid Khan, a Williamson, a Warner. So that pretty much fits their 4 overseas slots. And if Kedar performs, I guess they'll not be even changing the combinations for the 14 matches. Unless and until he doesn't perform, they'll fiddle with the new players, be it Abhishek Sharma, Virat Singh, Priyam Garg. So they'll be looking into choices among these 3 players. But if Kedar performs, they'll not even stand a chance.
But I think SRH has been stuck. They were not able to find the middle ground. I mean, they had a pretty much inexperienced Indian lineup and a pretty much experienced international lineup. I mean, if you want every foreign player to play, I think SRH, nobody can beat SRH. But that's not the case, because you need to fill these slots with 4 players. I mean, there were many players that have been unsold, but whom do you think, who is that one player whom do you think that should have been picked?
Ask me. So, I would look into the case of Vihari. So, this guy was called upon for the 3rd time also and he went unsold. I don't know which team has called him. But a team like Rajasthan Royals can fit him, where they can get a solid Indian batsman, and they can have Joss Butler, Stokes, etc. playing around him. He would have suited the bill better over there.
I feel that South African middle order batsman Rassie van der Dessen not a lot of overseas batsmen were sold. Steve Smith himself went for a very low price. But if there is an overseas player who can play spin well, I think it's Van der Dessen. And, you know, South Africa are considering him as a long-term replacement for AB de Villiers. He showed his mettle, not that much, but he did prove a point in the 2019 World Cup. So I think him getting a chance for any IPL team would be beneficial both sides.
Yeah, and for me, it would be Alex Hales, actually. I was expecting that he would be picked by some team this time. And I was expecting maybe Chennai should have gone for him because they were looking for that opening batsman. And I felt that Alex fitted that bill. I mean, he's had a tremendous BBL this year. But still, that even the international call-up and IPL call-up seems to evade Hales, at least for now. Well, that's it, guys. So that's our analysis for the auctions that has happened in this season. So if you find any interesting analysis from this, or if you feel that there has been players that should have been picked and all, so please do mention in the comment section.